Republican.
I thought you mentioned Arkansas being the most interesting race. There you have an incumbent who had all kinds of pressure coming from right and left. She's facing a very tough general, having already won the primary. But it looked like she could lose the primary in the last couple of days because everyone was coming in there to beat her, the SEIU, the service employees, the state employees. And they were all coming in there to beat her with $10 million. And they really were after her. And they ironically made her into Norma Rae. Yeah. They made her into the local hero, yeah. woman who was standing up for her rights.
So she became the local versus the national establishment right. because all those unions have headquarters in Washington.
Right, and a lot of people came from out of town. It was one of those outside situations, and she managed to make herself a local hero and actually never looked better than she did election night. So what irony. What irony there.
She had a secret weapon, too, Bill Clinton.
Boy, that hug. That goes down in history. He had the French cuffs. He looked like $1 million. He put the full bill around her. It was really an embrace. And when you noticed, it was almost, well, it was gender, because when she came out of that hug, she was actually just overwhelmed physically. She was like, you could see in her face, I can't believe the guy likes me that much and wants to help me that much. It was great. It was very real.
The politics of it, he made a big difference for her because he brought out the local angle.
He won six races for governor down there and two races for president. He's very popular in that part of the country, in Arkansas. He may live in New York, but he's an Arkansan, and I think Hillary is as well. I'm telling you, the big message coming out of this is, if you're running, if you're Joe Sestak running for the Senate this fall, you want him in western Pennsylvania. You want him in the culturally conservative Democratic areas. You want him if you're Paul Hodes in New Hampshire. Another state where Bill Clinton's enormously popular is Pennsylvania and New Hampshire. If you're running in Ohio, you want him there. You want him in Missouri, Kentucky, all that sort of state, more rural states, you want him.
Okay,
in fact, you want him almost anywhere.
So what does this mean for him, in terms of what he may be and what he may do?
Well, I've been convinced that the most powerful political fact on the center-left in American politics for the last 2 years has been what's not called but is, in fact, the coalition between the Clintons and Barack Obama. It's been sealed by her appointment as Secretary of State, his recognition of her as basically as foreign minister, giving her full authority to fill almost all the posts in that department. Bill Clinton coming along as a full partner in this three-way relationship. It's powerful stuff, and I think if it hadn't occurred, think of the opposite. Her is a senator in New York, a lightning rod for all concerns about the Middle East, about unemployment. But instead, she's on the team and very much a partner on the team. And Bill Clinton's on the team. Who would have believed that he would have been such a good partner as he's been? 100%. She's been 100%. And I think if anything happens to that relationship, the Democratic Party comes apart. But as long as it holds, they're at least a 50-50 bet to hold the White House for two terms.
California, you have two former CEOs going to carry the standard for the Republican Party.
Fiorino, I don't think, can win a general election because she's pro-life. Now, she may have taken that position, opposition to Roe v. Wade, opposition to a woman's right to choose an abortion. But having taken that position for all these months, she now has to stand by that position in the general. I think that may be a Faustian deal for her. I think it'll be a real problem. They haven't elected a pro-life candidate out there for major office since Dumasian. Way back in the 80s.
Governor Dumagin.
Yeah, they're not supportive. So she'll have a problem. Whitman, I think, is a 50-50 shot. The money that she can put on the table. Now, as you understand, there's tracking polls. So every 3 days you can get an average of your polls. Mm-hmm. And as long as she sees herself within striking distance, she'll peel off another $5 million. And another $5 million, another $5 million. So as she gets closer, Jerry Brown himself told me this years ago, in California, you can buy up your ratings. Now, at some point, it becomes, as we say in math, asymptotic. You don't quite get there.
And so what happened in South Carolina with Nikki Haley?
Well, she was under assault. Again, I think people out there, those men were not showing good form. I mean, that's a nice old phrase.
What does that mean?
It means they were saying things about they had relations with her, and they're putting that word out in the street.
Yeah.
And I think people...
Well, they didn't put it out in the street. They did commercials.
Well, that's right. They didn't do it with much subtlety. But the fact is that she, first of all, dare I say it on late night television, she's a very attractive person. I think people like her. She's very well turned out. She's very metropolitan.
And what are her views?
I think she has all of the arch conservative views, but she seems to lay it on a little bit more nicely.